He's well known around the old capital as Mr. Pow, specifically for those delicious meat pies, hot out the oven on New Road, and now can be bought at several locations across the north and south sides of Belize City. But on Sunday, Arthur Francisco passed away peacefully, leaving behind 3 daughters and 12 grandchildren, among other relatives. Francisco was well respected and loved in society and was known as a man of discipline and dedication.
I knew him as a young boy growing up in this area, Douglas Street, Jones Street, New Road. And then I knew him more as an adult in terms of his spirituality. I've seen his discipline both as a human being in terms of treating people the way how he reacts. And he would discipline everyone and anyone, doesn't matter if you're a child or you're an adult. I think that's what people respected about him, and that's why he was so all-encompassing of people. And he took his spirituality very seriously, of course, you know, to the point where he was ordained as a minister. And when you reach that point, you know that you're serious both about God and man.
Up until his passing, Francisco was a member of the Emmanuel International Church. But back in 1999, his beloved friend, Apostle Joy Street, ordained him as a pastor of a Church of God in Christ. According to Pastor Street, she first met Brother Francisco back in 1982 when she first came to Belize as a 29-year-old missionary.
I lived right there with them on New Road, I believe, and I was there, and that was my first encounter with him, with them. And from that time, a lifelong friendship. As I was telling my congregation yesterday when I was breaking the news to them, I said, we didn't just lose a church member, but I lost a friend. He was a friend to me. Over the years, seeing him go from church member back in that time, a deacon, and later he told me he was pastoring a church there on North Front Street, Church of God in Christ, Turner's Church of God in Christ, something like that. And I said, great. I said, well, who ordained you? Do you have your license? And he said, no, I just have a small congregation and I teach. And I said, well, you know what? You need to be honored as the pastor of that congregation. I said, would you want me to ordain you? And he said, yes, I would like that. He says, I need it.
But while he's known as a man of the cloth, Francisco was also an athlete in his younger years. In 1966, he represented Belize at the Commonwealth Games in Jamaica in the weightlifting category. Belize has lost yet another icon, and his legacy lives on in the memory of his family and residents who have had an encounter with Francisco.
When you lose somebody with that kind of discipline, responsibility, mannerism, the whole community suffers because he was known and he was loved. And I believe everyone in this era, as a matter of fact, in the whole Belize City era, will definitely grieve for him and his family because they know the support that he has given to the area. And of course, he was a family man, very, very liked by his family, loved by his family. And he exaggerated that in the love for his community.
What I learned from Brother Arturo, or Pastor Arturo, as I called him lately, he was a man of commitment, persevering man. He was a disciplined man. But he was a kind and a gentleman. That he was a boxer earlier, but he was a gentleman. And he was a jovial man, and he played harmonica. He was always a helpful, nurturing guy.
And of course, people can still enjoy Pow's Meat Pies on New Road.
I wasn't a regular, but yes, I have contributed and patronized the shop now and again. So I wouldn't say that I'm a regular, but yes, because I knew the product is a good product, yes, I would definitely visit and purchase.
Dwayne Moody for News 5.